We can begin. Ladies and gentlemen.
Good afternoon. My team and I took on the task of evaluating Marisol's current online presence and creating a strategic campaign to enhance it.
Marisol's Cafe has a distinct slogan of serving the sexiest coffee and the studliest sandwiches in town. With a heavy focus on creating a relaxed and family-oriented environment, Marisol's offers supreme value and quality to their customers. Their signature drink, the Chippy, is self-proclaimed supercharged, super sexy coffee beverage. As it stands, Marisol's has an incredible opportunity to use online presence to expand their audience reach and determine potential locations for a new brick-and-mortar store. Our goals for the proposed online presence campaign are bold: build overall brand, organize routine postings, listen and respond to customer needs, and develop a strong online following. To achieve these goals, we will refine Marisol's current content, create new avenues, and expand our audience through a three-step process. They are located roughly 1 mile away from the University of Massachusetts Dartmouth, which has around 11,000 students and faculty, so their target market consists primarily of college students. Because of this target market's age, it is imperative to have a strong online presence. We define online presence as the collective existence of a product or company mainly through website design, search engine optimization, and social media marketing. The overall impression that a company can leave on a potential customer is critical when determining strong versus weak online presence. The key sign of strong online presence is capturing and converting as many leads as possible. We gathered our definition from attending Engage Conference in New York City, taking social media marketing classes, attending workshops, and conducting online research.
We applied our definition to Marisol's Cafe and found that they have a neutral online presence. They have a somewhat strong search engine optimization, but are only utilizing their company website and minimal social media channels like Facebook and Instagram. They recently updated their website and do have their current menu items listed on it. However, their other content is extremely outdated. This website features outdated pictures of products that they don't even offer anymore, and a contest that even ended back in 2012.
That's a great piece.
This is a very ineffective use of their website, which should ultimately just be an extension of their store culture. As for their selected social media channels, Facebook is definitely their most popular one. They currently have over 12,000 likes on their page, but only average about 100 likes per post. That's about a 0.8% interaction rate, which is the percentage of followers who like their posts. Marisol's doesn't interact with their customers online, nor do their posts get shared by their followers. As for Instagram, they have about 1,700 followers and average around 100 likes per post too. That's a 5.8% interaction rate. On both of these social media channels, their posts are very sporadic, and when they do post, it's usually a funny meme that doesn't reflect the overall brand well. On the rare occasion that they do actually post a product, customers respond very well to these posts and they can receive up to 10 times the amount of likes they normally get. This shows that their customers want to engage, but they aren't given the opportunity very often. Overall, Marisol's does have a good customer following online, however, they lack conveying their brand and promoting products online. If they want to capitalize on the opportunity to reach a larger audience and pinpoint where they want to create their new location, Marisol's must address their online presence above all.
Once we had gathered our thoughts on the cafe's online presence, we conducted an informational interview with the owner, Richard Romero. We wanted to get a gauge on where he thinks Marisol stands in the realm of social media, marketing tactics online, their target market, and we wanted to learn what specific goals he had in mind for our plan. Initially, he wanted to learn how customers were reacting to the newly updated website and how effective their social media was. But after greater discussion, he realized that our research could be a stepping stone to help him open a second location. From this interview and our other research to this point, we were able to create a SWOT analysis for the cafe. In terms of strengths, we have a great location right on Route 6, which is central to a lot of shopping and the University of Massachusetts Dartmouth, which drives a lot of business during the academic year. They also have a relatively strong local social media presence, but their weaknesses are that they have minimal social media interaction compared with their follower count. And though the website is updated, as Shannon mentioned earlier, some of their information is very out of date. And they also lack adequate parking in a drive-thru, which is a big complaint for the students. Their opportunities are that the people in the area do have a tendency to support local businesses as opposed to large corporations, and there's a young audience that is really susceptible to their general vibe. The major threats they face are a Dunkin' Donuts and a Starbucks right in the same plaza, and the decrease in population once school lets out for the summer. Phase two of the research was distributing an online survey to the cafe's customers. Our goals for the survey were to learn how customers had heard of the cafe, their thoughts on the new website, what social media they would like to see the cafe on, what social media they follow the cafe on, and what kind of content they were most likely to respond to. We were hesitant to upfront ask about the second store because it hadn't been publicly announced by the owner and we didn't want to cross any lines there. So we ended up learning basic demographics of the respondents. The survey was distributed on Marisol's Facebook page. There were 550 responses, which we took as a great sign that their posts have a lot of reach and their audience responds well to posts when there's a call to action. We were interested to learn that 88% of respondents were female. And of the 550 responses, 254 of the respondents are currently in school, with 75% of that number attending UMass Dartmouth, and the remaining 25% attending schools within a 30-mile radius. Another interesting fact is that 83% had heard of Marisol's from a friend, family, or coworker. Another 12% just stopped by on a whim while they were driving around. So only 5% had learned of them from social media. Fortunately, 75% found the website to be somewhat to very accessible, easy to use, and organized, despite the not updated information. When asked what social media they would like to see the cafe on, 60% of respondents said Snapchat and 27% said Twitter. The final key question was what content they were most likely to interact with. 42% said promotional offers, for example, 10% off of your purchase if you post on social media. 29% said giveaways or contests, such as a picture contest for a $50 gift card, and the rest of the respondents were evenly split between informational posts, photos, and surveys. We found this question particularly interesting because when asked for their final overall thoughts, a lot of respondents said that they wanted to see more daily postings of soup of the day, sandwich of the day, chippy flavors of the day, and that they also wanted to see more photos of their products instead of what's currently being posted.
From our research findings, we knew that improving Marisol's online presence was crucial to reaching a new audience and the formation of a new brick and mortar storefront. After analyzing Marisol's current clients, what they think about the business online, we developed a list of goals that we believe will address this opportunity. Our goals are BOLD. BOLD stands for Build Overall Brand, Organize Routine Postings, Listen and Respond to Customer Needs, and Develop a Strong Online Following. With BOLD in mind, we could effectively develop our strategic campaign to strengthen Marisol's online presence now.
Once we gathered and analyzed our research findings, we created a three-step process to refine, create, and expand to achieve our goals. Step one is refining their current social media channels. The content they currently post consists of sporadic photos of their food and drinks, mixed with many memes related to sporting events like the Super Bowl or weather-related anytime there is supposed to be snow. Their social media doesn't necessarily convey the vibe of the cafe, which is a shame because it is creating a disconnect as these sites should be a direct extension of the store. By refining their posts to reflect the atmosphere of the cafe, and this will likely increase their percentage of people that learn about the cafe through social media channels. This refined Facebook and Instagram content will be photos of menu items, reposting customer photos, and include more giveaways and promotions. We want the customers to see new posts and immediately think Marisol's Cafe. This refined content ties back into the B in BOLD, building overall brand. Step two is creating new social media channels consisting of Snapchat and Twitter. Snapchat is an easy way for customers to keep up with what is going on at the cafe. As Sarah said, our research showed that 60% would like to see Snapchat so they can see daily chippy flavors, soup, and sandwich offerings. The second social media channel they need to make is Twitter, as 27% of the respondents indicated they would like to see Twitter, which may seem minuscule, but 70% of respondents indicated that they use Twitter. Twitter will serve as an anchor for every other channel, so they can put out the posts needed throughout the day for instant content. The creation of these new channels ties back into the O and L of Bold, which is our goal of organizing routine posts and listening and responding to customer needs. Step 3 is the expansion of Marisol's into new audiences, which will eventually culminate in a new storefront. It is no question that food trucks and pop-ups are a huge trend. Fortunately, Marisol's already has the chippy truck, however, it is not currently in use. We believe that by revitalizing the truck, Marisol's can beta test possible store locations. As Sarah stated previously, customers are coming in from a 30-mile radius to get their Marisol's fix. They are coming from several universities in the surrounding areas, such as Bridgewater State University, Community College of Rhode Island, and Bristol Community College. Therefore, we think we should set up a pop-up shop in or around these universities. In doing this, Marisol's can learn which locations are most suitable for a new store, and because food trucks are so trendy, they'll make their online presence explode. This expansion to new audiences ties back to the D in Bold, developing strong online following.
In order to gauge the success of Bold, we have devised a few key metrics that we would like the cafe to hit. The first is in relation to customer engagement. So, on average, Marisol's gets less than 1% of their customers to interact with their posts. We took a look at other similar companies in the area and found that their average interactions were closer to 5%, meaning that for every post, at least 5 of their followers liked it. Ideally, the pages will hit this number pretty quickly once the content is refined. Another metric we've devised in terms of engagement is to repost 2 to 3 customer photos a week. This will show that they are interacting with customers and posting relevant content enough for people to see their offerings on a regular basis. In addition to the reposting, they should also be interacting with customers by responding to mentions or tags and posting on all of their social media platforms at least once a day. This will keep them in people's news feeds on a regular basis so they don't get lost in the weeds. The follower count should also be monitored. We would like to see a 10% increase per month for the first 6 months on the Instagram account with the new content, and then 5% per month from there on out. We also expect to see a large influx of followers to the newly created Snapchat and Twitter accounts. So once those have studied out, we would like to see a 5% increase as well. Finally, we recommend putting together another survey to learn what changes that we have implemented were successful and learn which of them need to be revisited. We expect the cafe to keep track of which locations of the chippy truck get the most customers week after week to determine which location could be most suitable for the new brick and mortar store. There should be a positive correlation between which location has the most visitors and which location helps them gain the biggest following online. They will also be keeping track of any fluctuations in customers that go to the store during these time frames that the truck is also out, to make sure that opening a second location doesn't take customers away but expands their client base to new horizons.
In terms of dollar amounts, Marisol stands to increase their year one revenue by $7,340. Based on our estimates from various online research, Bold is projected to bring in an additional $48,000 in sales during the first year, and the sky's the limit for the years to follow. The cost of further updating the website and training Marisol's new social media and website intern, and the various expenses that make up revitalizing the chippy truck will be $39,660. As Alex mentioned previously, Marisol's is located a mile away from the University of Massachusetts Dartmouth and can utilize the college's business school by hiring a social media and website intern. Not only is this extremely cost effective, but it allows the student to gain real world business experience. While the additional revenue is nothing to sneeze at, Marisol's has the opportunity to take part in something much larger than just a food truck. Not only can they grow their loyal customer following in various surrounding areas, but they can focus in on which location will ultimately be the most profitable to expand their brand to. We believe that by refining the content, creating new channels, and expanding their audience to sustain their new brick and mortar, Marisol's can stay bold in the realm of online presence. Thank you so much for your time. Do you guys have any questions?
Fifteen. Just over 15.
We're on the mark.
Well, they didn't start right at the beginning, so maybe
true.
It was like a minute off. But I was thinking that.
Okay, so we talked yesterday about trying to keep it under 15.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because 15's...
Because then it gives you 5 minutes for questions. Mm-hmm. We know we never have that many, but we don't want to cut it too short.
Sarah and I had a lot, actually, day two last year.
You did have.
We probably
it depends on the judge, yeah.
We had a bunch.
Do you have a time limit for the overall...
20.
20 minutes.
Including questions.
Okay. I would frame it as... What are your questions? How can we help you understand our proposal? Right, because, yeah.
Assume they have questions.
Assume
okay.
the things, right? What are
Assume
your questions?
Assume that they have questions. So, just as a frame of reference, it is required that they're off notes. So they will have no
yeah.
notes on
okay.
This is their first
yeah,
time presenting
was,
to us.
Yeah.
They will
okay.
not be reading off of
okay.
papers. They will not even have note cards.
Minor.
They will be off notes.
Really?
Totally off notes.
Yeah.
Okay? That's a total requirement.
And I've seen them all do it before.
Yeah,
I was
they
just
going
to
know.
Say,
they
I think you already could have
yeah.
been.
Yeah.
I think
yeah,
you've relied a lot on that.
We
oh, you too.
Our
yeah.
You too.
Script,
yeah.
Like
yeah. You were good
because
you were already wigging it.
Yeah.
But you two are relying way too much on those. You
Fuller.
Said the word studliest, and we're not even excited about it.
We've been working on that. We've been working on
studliest. Exactly.
Yeah.
He's
tired.
Haven't had a meal in like 5 days. About to pass
Shouldn't
out.
Shouldn't it make
just...
you laugh even if you're reading
this?
Yeah.
I saw you at Chipotle last night.
Called out.
Until you can get to the cafe.
Yeah, we only need it, Marisol.
Yeah.
yeah.
It's
part of the project.
Yeah. So I'm not going to talk a lot about the presentation stuff because you know it. You two have been in my class, so we've been working on that anyway. I know you've got it. It's just a matter of practice. Shannon knows it too. The move. Can I just talk about something? Because we've been having these offbeat conversations about sort of this since yesterday. Move. I would say move or open a second location. Because I would leave that open
or
to...
Or a second location.
Okay.
Yeah, I would leave that open to... I don't care what Richard thinks.
Yeah.
Okay.
Do I
right.
say that?
Yeah,
I mean,
we're done.
That's,
we're
on,
like,
that's
yeah.
on film now, Jeff.
You're actually trying to make some recommendations.
Right.
And whether he takes them or not, it doesn't really matter. I think the thing is that this online stuff is going to help to drive some of those decisions.
Mm-hmm.
Or that's what you were... suggesting.
This online presence will help to reduce the very real risks associated with increasing your fixed cost structure and losing customers through a move.
Because it'll give you some information that you didn't have previously by bolstering that up. Your role in this, is that what you were looking at? Like what their role should be? Because we talked about this. Who are you presenting to me? Who are you? What's your role? Do you remember?
Sarah, Shannon, and Alex.
I believe you're marketing interns or marketing...
We're executives.
Something.
No,
you're pitching to
the
business owner,
marketing.
Is that the idea?
Well,
what's their role?
It's
their role in there.
No,
we are.
Really,
well,
you
no, it's
didn't
not here.
Yeah,
well,
yes.
We normally do that. We normally go through, like, shake everyone's hand
okay.
and say that.
Yeah, you should see.
That
do it at the front again. Because a lot of people forget your name
no,
the first time you introduce
it's
yourself.
Right, right.
And it's a good way to start.
Uh-huh.
It helps you kind of, like,
guidelines for presentation, student instructions.
And we also do it, like, distract the judges. Because we're, like, setting up posters
yeah.
and stands. So, like, someone usually distracts
no,
them while, like, the other two are setting it up.
Is that all part of your time? Like,
yeah.
It is all
it's
part
like once we walk into the room, like time
go.
Starts.
It's like a show.
Yeah, it is
it's
a show.
Build
yeah.
the conversation.
I read somewhere.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
I read somewhere where your role is. And the role of the
judge.
Then
you started referring
person.
To each other.
Yeah,
then
you're like,
I was playing the role of I'm just, I don't know you
I know.
Guys,
well,
so
I'm taking notes on you. And I'm like, I don't know who's who, but I'll just keep reading. And then you said her, so I'm like, oh, I know who you are now. Figure it out.
Boy one.
Yeah. I mean, I have questions about the budget. I mean, where did the numbers come from?
Yeah,
we did a lot of budgets. Like some of them were a lot smaller, like for example, the trippy truck, the insurance, some of them said like $200 to $300, other ones said like $5,000.
Don't they already have the trippy mobile though?
They do, but I'm assuming that's not insured because it's not on the road right now. It's just sitting in the
back.
It's
not registered.
Yeah.
It's not insured.
Well, so
not
a, it might, I guess it doesn't matter.